Hello everyone, welcome back to Strings and Strokes. So today we are going to paint a shell in watercolors. For that I will only be using these colors that you can see on your screen. Along with this I'm going to be kneading a paper towel to wipe my brush, because in the watercolors you need something to wipe your brush with time and time again. Then two brushes that I'm using, you can see the sizes, and some water. So let's get started with the drawing. This is my reference image that I'm using, and I am going to start with looking at the angle of my drawing. So my angle is a slant, and now I am dividing my shell into two triangles. The lower triangle on the right and the upper triangle on the left side. It becomes really easy when you divide your drawing into shapes, so you're able to see the shapes. That makes it easy for you. So I think you definitely should use this tip to carry on with your basic drawing. There's no need for you to add any details until you have completed the outline. And as I always say, draw with a very, very light hand, because it's easy for you to erase if you want to make any improvements. Otherwise, darker drawing leaves a very dark mark on the surface of the paper, which makes it nearly impossible for you to erase that without spoiling your paper. Once you're done with the placement of your drawing and you have decided what angle it is in, you can start adding the details only after you have the outlines ready. The details would include the texture, the type of lines that you see. As you can see, there are some ridges on the shell. There are some, you know, rough textures, contour lines, some scales that you would see on the shell. So we will start adding all those details as soon as our basic shape is ready. So our outline drawing is almost ready. We can start applying the watercolor. The first and the foremost layer of watercolor would be very slight paint, or even just the water. If you want to do the technique of wet and wet, then you should only apply the water. I am also only applying the water with a very light hand, with a very light tint of yellow, which is my base tint here. The second layer of painting would be the slight darker tone that you see, which is a very pale orange. So that's what I'm applying anywhere I can see that orange tone in my shell. Again, with very watery consistency, very slight washes all over the shell that I can see the orange paint. And the third color that I'm applying is the crimson red. My base layer has slightly dried up, so I'm adding a slight darker layer of the tones of orange and burnt sienna that I can see around my shell. keep in mind that we always go from light to dark when we are doing the watercolors. Also, artists don't usually apply the white paint while they are painting in watercolors. White paint creates a lot of opacity. That's the reason artists don't apply it. Watercolor is a transparent medium, and the beauty of the watercolor is that transparency. So try avoiding that watercolor. Although the funny part is that I myself has used a white watercolor in my later layers to give the highlight. I have never done this before, but I felt that there's something missing. A few highlights were missing, so I thought it's a good idea to give some textures with the watercolor, with the white paint that I've used at the end. But it's very important for you to know the rules, to know the basics. This is completely your choice if you want to add a background to your painting or not. Sorry for the exposure, it changed and it's actually looking super bright. I know that, but I couldn't do anything about it later on. So yeah, so background is an option. If you want to do it, you can do it. If not, that's absolutely fine as well. I am almost nearly done. So if you liked this video, if it helped you learn something, then please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. All the best with your painting work.